On behalf of Indira Gandhi National Open University, myself, Professor Subhashish Maji, in Mechanical Engineering Department of School of Engineering and Technology, presenting today the most important topic, that is customers involvement and product participation. This topic is from ACPDM program, that is Advanced Certificate in Power Distribution Management program. And this is unit 3 of the course BEE003, that is Management of Power Distribution. In our earlier discussion, we started with the lecture on aspects of management. There we have discussed in detail the management processes like planning, controlling, organizing, and leading. Those processes are absolutely necessary for running the organizations to get its desired output. After that, we discussed about customer relationship management, that is also very important in order to keep the organization's profit at their expectations. Now, today we are discussing about the topic, that is customer involvement and participation. Before discussing, we will first discuss little bit on the power distribution sector. In electric sector, that three important elements are there: power generation, power transmission, and power distribution. Power is generated at the power generating center. If you consider it is a thermal power plant, then coal is burned. In the boiler, a heat is generated, and that heat is being utilized for converting water into steam. That high pressure, high temperature steam will pass through the turbine, and the turbine rotates. The shaft of the turbine is coupled with the shaft of the generator, which is producing electricity. Now, generally power is generated at a voltage of 2.3 kilovolt to 22 kilovolt. Now, it is being transmitted over a long distance through the transmission line, and it is transmitted at a very high voltage, around 800 kilovolt or even 1200 kilovolt, to reduce the power loss due to the, we call it is a technical loss. And power loss is defined as I square R, where I is the current and R is the resistance of the conductor. So we have to keep the voltage high, because power is equal to voltage into current. If you increase voltage, current will be less. So at a low magnitude current, we have to transmit. Now, therefore, we have to use a step-up transformer at the power generating center. And the purpose of this step-up transformer is transform low voltage, high current to high voltage, low current, so that current will be low and voltage will be high. That is the purpose of the step-up transformer. But at the same time, generally we use power at the voltage of 220 or 400 volt. So we have to reduce the voltage from high voltage to the voltage as per our domestic or any customer's purpose. Now, there are losses, and these losses are enormous. And you will be surprised to know that 25% loss is there for the we call it the technical loss, and these losses are related to the transmission loss or the different equipment which are being used in the power distribution sector or generating sector. Some losses are there. Say, for example, there is loss in transformer, or there is loss in power distributing to the end users. And so that losses is around 25%, and there is a loss, we call it commercial loss. And this commercial loss is also very high, and this commercial loss is due to pilferage of power, that is theft of power, and tampering of the meter and some unlawful activities carried out by the customers who will not pay the bill. At the same time, they think that it is their right to get the power. Now, we have to reduce both the losses, either transmission loss or this commercial losses. Now, technical loss and commercial loss have to be reduced in order to the survival of the power utility organizations. Now, customer has to play a vital role for reducing the commercial losses, which are mainly due to the pilferage of electricity or the theft of power, tampering of meters, or somehow without paying, some people are using power. Now, how the customers are to be involved and participate so that the organizations will get benefit by reducing the power losses, especially the commercial losses? That is our discussion. First of all, let us see that what the customer needs. The general customers, they need that power has to be supplied round the clock, 24/7, and there should not be any power cut, there should not be disruptions of power supply, and power has to be supplied all the time, because we all depend on the availability of electric power for every works of our life. Now, there are some, say, quality of power, that is mainly the frequency. Generally, we use frequency around 50 hertz for using our electrical equipment, and that 50 hertz power is necessary. But power supply should be such that the available frequency should be within the range of 49 hertz to 50.5 hertz. The power has to be supplied in a frequency which lies in between 49 hertz to 50.5 hertz. Any frequency beyond this range is not acceptable, and there may be chances of damaging for the equipment like TV, fridge, air conditioner, and any electrical or electronic equipments we are using with the help of electric power. At the same time, that the billing should be proper. Sometimes the customers they get wrong billing, or a bill which is not people will not be able to read. That printing is so bad that they are facing difficulties that how much they have to pay or on what date they have to pay. And at the same time, there should be ease in submitting the bill. You must be remembering that around 10 or 15 years back, we have to stand in the queue in the electrical, service offices to pay the bill. But that should not be there. Why the customer should wait for 2-3 hours for in the queue for submitting their bill? It should be user friendly. And nowadays, you have seen that we can pay the bills without any difficulty. At the same time, if there is any difficulty for the customer, if any customer make any complaints, that has to be sorted out within a very short time. Now, today's discussion is how customer involvement and participation improves the whole process of the power utility. Our focus should be how consumer participation can help the utilities in improving their performance in terms of increasing their revenue collection through payment of bills and reducing losses through power theft and illegal connections. and there are so many illegal connections are there. That illegal connections are especially for unauthorized, say, colonies and unapproved colonies or JJ clusters. We call it Jhuggi Jhupri clusters. Then how to overcome these difficulties? That is our today's discussions, and we will take up some case studies at the end of our discussion. See, we need to understand that electricity is an industry and not a social service. Some people may think that it is their right to use electricity, and they get the electricity by any means, by hooking and without bypassing the meter and using electricity. But that is a wrong practice, and they should not. And everybody should be concerned that if there are the losses are more, definitely the burden will come onto the shoulder of the genuine customers who are regularly paying their electricity bills. Revenue losses, in which consumers are directly involved, result in many forms that we have already discussed, that non-payment of electricity bills, tariff, subsidies, illegal connections, and power theft. Now you see that the different governments are giving subsidy, and in Delhi, you know very well that the Delhi government has given subsidy for zero electricity bill if the bill is coming below 200 unit. But you will be surprised to know that most of the genuine persons who are willing to pay the electricity bill, but since their bills are coming below 200 unit, so they get bill at zero rupees. That means they need not have to pay. And you see that for 200 unit bill generally comes out to be around 672 rupees. So if 1 lakh people get the zero bill, then you can calculate how much losses government has to incur for giving these subsidies. Of course, subsidies have to be given for the below poverty level persons, but we have to give them in a proper way so that the government should not make a tremendous loss on this. And power theft is a genuine problem. There are other factors like inefficient billing and harsh procedure for consumer that affect payment. Now, for billing maladies, what are the difficult scenarios are there for billing? That is software mistake. There may be software mistakes and bills may come exorbitant amount. And after that, the consumer have to go to their utilities offices or customer center, and they will tell the story for one person. The first person to whom they are telling, the customer is telling their difficulties. They may not understand what is the difficulties, and they will simply pass on to the second person. Now the customer will tell the same story to the second person. Again, the second person will say, look, I have to transfer this problem to the billing section or software engineers. Now again, the customer have to tell the same story again and again, and therefore after few hours, when the customers are not getting their genuine solution, and they will be more frustrated. And delays in audit, off cycle billing, non-existent consumers. Sometimes the billing is coming to a house where there is no resident or no persons at all. Then incorrect identification of category, and non-reading or incorrect meter reading, faulty bill, lack of reconciliations, and prolonged disputes and connivance. So these are the different problems for the billing thing, billings for in the billing process. So the billing has to be proper so that the genuine persons can pay the bill in time without any difficulty. Now, providing better services, why should the customer be involved? This is a genuine question. That providing better service means the utility, the organizations which are supplying the electricity to us, it is their responsibility. But they must know what are the difficulties the genuine customers are facing. And in that case, the customer has to give proper information, and let us discuss how the customer involvement and participation will improve the whole system. Now see, when you think of better revenue management, so if you think of a organizational structure, it should be like that, the meter reading and meter management. That is very important, that the meter reading has to be perfect. There should not be any fault in meter reading. After that, the revenue billing collections and revenue recovery. That is also very important, because after getting the bill, the customer, when they will pay the bill, the process has to be user-friendly. And consumer management, customer care, and PR, that is very, very important. So we will focus our attention on this aspect. And of course, regulatory system is also one of the crucial point to be discussed today. Now we see that consumer management, customer care, and PR, these are very, very vital things, that there has to be a customer care where any person can lodge any complaint round the clock, and then the management should know what are the drawbacks in the system, what are the problems the customers are facing. And the main motto for any organizations is to make happy for their customers, and it should be customer-centric organizations, because there are a lot of competitions in the market. So the organizations must see that how they can retain their customers, and the customers have to be loyal customers. See, for customer survey, that interact better with customers, answer customers' inquiries quickly and accurately, obtain information about customer problems, their concerns and feedback, and attend to their problems fast. So these are very important, that when any customer faces any difficulty, that the utilities organizations, they who are supplying electricity, they have to attend the customer's complaint genuinely, and they should not think that it is a burden for the organization. Rather, they should think it is the opportunity for the organizations to serve their customers in a better way, so that customers' loyalty will enhanced. Now, customer surveys can also help managers of the utility to obtain real-time trend information rather than end of the period updates. Link front line performance with corporate goals for customer satisfaction. That is very important. Develop reports and graphs from data specific to their area of responsibility. And this report they can publish in some local newspaper or some bulletins or pamphlets to be distributed to the customers. And they will also see that their views are been taken care of. So analyze data, display the type, region, product or service line, injury or catastrophic event, units responsible, root cause, volume, etc., and enhance customer contacts. See, once we know our consumers and their requirements and expectations, we could build a healthy relationship with our customers by creating mutual trust for the benefits of both. For utilities to earn profit, if the organizations are running very efficiently, if they are supplying the goods to the customers as per their expectations, and in turn the customers are paying for their items which they are receiving, here it is electricity, and definitely it is a win-win situation for the organizations as well as the customers. For customers, reliable and quality power supply for improving the quality of life. Now, if there is any fault and if there is any disruptions of power and if there is any power cut for any time, the information must be given to the customer, so that customers must know that this many hours there will be no electricity in that region, and they can plan accordingly and they will wait. But if there is no information, and definitely the customers will not be happy if there is a sudden power failure in any locality. Customer education and awareness programs about the power sector are needed to inform them about how they can benefit by adopting emerging technologies like automatic meter reading. Nowadays, automatic meter reading are introduced for reading the power energy, how much they have to pay for any particular month. So at AMR, when they are introducing any new thing, the customer must be, you know, aware of such new implementation, and regulate their energy demands and reduce their energy consumptions and electricity bills by adopting energy efficient appliances and equipment. Nowadays, that information and communication technologies are playing a vital role. Most of the power sector authorities are leveraging the power of information and communication technologies for enhancing the facilities given to the customers, and any information they can give to their customers through email or message, so that the customers will be knowing on what date they have to pay the bill and when that bill is generated. If there is any delay in generating bill due to any adverse situation, they must tell to the customers well in advance. But information and communication technology plays a very vital role for enhancing the whole system in a most efficient way. See, customer education and awareness program, this is very important, that they will gain, the customers will gain monetary benefit due to increased earning or employment opportunities in the power sector. Say, if the power sector is flourishing, and if they need some more, if they want to recruit some more people, and if the customer knows about this information, and any potential customer may apply for that post, so that there will be job opportunity for that also. Now, also gain other tangible benefits such as improvement in status, better opportunities for children, and improved quality of life. Now, this is also very important, because if electricity is provided round the clock, definitely they will tell to others that we are at Delhi and getting electricity all the time, and that better opportunities for the children, and so that children can study and make use the time efficiently. And of course, in turn, it will improve the quality of life for the consumers. Consumer care is also very important. Consumer care begins when we care for the consumer. If we don't care for the consumers, and definitely the question for consumer care doesn't arise. So consumer care begins when we care for the consumer. Consumers will know that we are concerned if we provide to them high quality and reliable electricity on the continuous basis. That is the need for the consumers. They are expecting that, consumers are expecting that they must get the power with a high quality with regard to the voltage and frequency and all time supply for their users. And good customer services, that is also very important. That includes understanding and respect. This is very important. And solution to problems, involvement in decision-making process, and open and clear procedures and policies. Now see, utilities should provide the following avenues for consumer participation and care. See, what the customer needs, they should have the facilities so that the organization should be approachable. That means any problem customer can tell to the organizations or power utilities authorities, so that their problems are readily solved. And this can be done by ample avenues for lodging complaint, ample billing and payment avenues, SMS alert for payment due to other information, effective help desk, and single window redressals, and transportation and remedies services, and promptness in providing new connections and load enhancement. This is very important. You know very well that if there is any new building constructed, or new mall constructed, it is very difficult to get the new connections because there are a lot of, say, official or bureaucratic steps are there, and in turn the things are delayed. So customers who need new connections, it has to be given very quickly. And avenues for lodging complaint include commercial call centers to deal with all kinds of bill and meter related complaint, helplines, and interactive voice recording system for reporting the harassment and safety issues, and consumer relation calls, and online consumer complaint cell. This has to be there so that the consumer can lodge problem, consumer may express their difficulties for using electricity, and in turn, if organizations get all information, they will improve the system so that the whole organizations will flourish and they will definitely get their profit as per their expectations, because power sector is an industry, it is not a social service. See, but one very interesting statistical, say, studies, one called a very interesting statistical studies conducted, and that there are several persons are using electricity, but you see that for this triangle at the bottom part is given as 50% who encounter a problem but do not complain. See, in Indian scenario, if anybody is having, say, suddenly if there is a power failure in that house, immediately they will ask their neighbor that, do you have any power? If the neighbor says that, no, we do not have any power, there is a power cut, so the first person will be happy, okay, it is not our only problem, there are some other persons are also facing the problem, let it be like this, and the electricity will come as per its own time, so they will not complain. So 50% of the consumers will never complain, but 40% the genuine the consumer, a concerned consumer, they will complain to the complaint lodged office or call centers, and 5% affluent class, they will complain to the management, that is the general manager of that particular organization, that this is happening, so please see, and they will utilize their own status and all. But out of that 45%, if the problems are solved, that means it is fine, they will be empowered. That problem solved quickly, customer loyalty maintained, employee pride and moral maintained. But if the problems are not solved, that means there will be a problem for the consumer, and in terms, what are the effects? Like problem solving requires manager. So the problem will be shifted to the higher ups, and manager has to intervene for sorting out the problem, and delays and cost increase, customer loyalty affected, and employee pride and moral decreased. So these are the drawbacks. So suppose the complaints are solved easily. One experience I am having, because I now everything is online. Today I am giving online lecture. We are having online conference, online webinar, and online classes. So our internet facilities has to be there. And we were having low GB for the internet connections. So we went to we applied for higher GB with higher payment, but it was not activated. We went to the MTNL office, but only few persons are there because this is a lockdown period, and we went the top officials. Then I requested, kindly, I am faculty of Indira Gandhi National Open University. We are now surviving only with the availability of internet and electricity, and kindly give proper electricity, internet connections, because previously we paid for a 750 rupees scheme, now we are applying for a 1200 rupees scheme, and our speed has gone down very low, so please solve this problem. So I requested, kindly solve the problem within 2 days, but that gentleman said that, why 2 days, I will solve your problem within 2 hours, you reach there before reaching to your home. You see that your problem is solved. When I come back to my home, then I found that the internet facilities are as per my expectation. I was so happy. So my complaints converted to compliments. So here you see, from complaints, the complaint means somebody may say, I have written in February and again in June, now it is September, I still have not had a satisfactory response. What do I have to do to get someone to listen to me? So these are the complaints. But if the complaints are readily solved, definitely the customers will be happy. And they may say, I wish to thank you and your department for your expeditious and thorough considerations and solving my problem. Mr. So-and-so was able to provide me with the necessary information. The follow-up was a surprise and good example of real interest in my problem. This kind of thoughtfulness and follow-up is greatly appreciated. If the customer says, then it will, the complaints may convert to compliments. So the organization should not think a complaint as a drawback for any organization. They should think that complaint means there is a scope for improvement for the organization, for so that they should get their profit as per their expectations. So avenues of billing collections, that intensive inspection have to be there, identifying areas where payment history is bad, effective disconnections and defaulters, leveling at customer premises, and ignoring complaints of defaulters in case of faults localized to them, and fixing accountability of officials of utility covering the areas. Sometimes what is happening, that officials, they ignore. If something is going on, they ignore. If some theft is going on, they ignore. But they are not understanding that if they ignore those bad practices, they are virtually doing bad things for the growth of their own organization. Now we see that public relations unit of a utility should be made responsible for customer care, for building the corporate image of the utility. This will require proactive interactions with customer forums, keeping consumer abreast with future plans and initiatives, consumer counseling. This is very important, taking pains to get consumers' beliefs on utility commitment. Now, you see the consumer groups and franchise model, this is also a very important thing, that consumer groups such as the following can help the utility achieve its target. The Residents Welfare Association, Market Association, Industrial Area, Societies, Schools, NGOs, JJ Clusters, local leaders and social workers. You know very well that previously Delhi Vidyut Board was there, and they have launched a project with collaborations with USAID, that United States Agencies for International Development, and they consider two JJ clusters, that Jhuggi Jhupri clusters, to provide electricity, and they enlightened the plus point of having genuine electricity or a legal way of getting electricity, and they informed that this is a beautiful scheme, and the scheme was like that initially they have to pay 350 rupees one time and 50 rupees per month for 2 years. That means 24 months. This is the amount they have to pay. That means after that, and those 350 rupees one time and 50 rupees per month for 2 years, that amount will be for providing the electricity, and that amount for developing the infrastructure for providing electricity for them. After that, only 175 rupees electricity bill per month will come, and they will get electricity of 2 ampere connections of 440 watt. And you will be surprised to know that model was very much successful, and so many JJ clusters, that is Jhuggi Jhupri clusters, that people got that electricity in a legal way. So if you educate them how to get the electricity in a legal way, they will also be very happy to use electricity with no fear of say if this fear of unnecessary that getting electricity through other means. Now, franchises model at the delivery end, objectives of the franchises scheme are promote public participation for bringing effectiveness in the present distribution arrangement for reducing theft, conducting maintenance and distributions on community basis through the distribution franchises, and encourage community management in the maintenance of distribution lines for production and promotion, attract private investment in distributing through the distributing franchisee, and promote technical and managerial capability of the beneficiaries in the field of electricity distribution through institutional capacity building and training efforts. One very important case studies I would like to express here, tell here, that is the NDPL, that North Delhi Power Limited. They in 1st July 2002, when the privatizations occurred, then they decided that they will provide electricity to unauthorized persons and JJ clusters, Jhuggi Jhupri clusters, and resettlement areas where there was no electricity. So they initially they have given this responsibility to the contractors, who will provided 700 single point delivery to different clusters, and one single point delivery for if any contractor gets one single point delivery, they will get, they will provide different say electrical points to several houses. But what happened, initially 700 single point delivery through the contractor, they, when they have given these facilities, after that what happened, the most powerful contractors, they grabbed all the work and they started collecting money illegally more and exploiting the poor persons. After that, the NDPL, that is North Delhi Power Limited, they invited franchises, they implemented franchises arrangement, and there were 210 SPD, that single point delivery system, they were given, and they in turn they were getting around 27% that is rebate. The contractors, they were getting 25% rebate for the for these services, and 2% extra rebate they were giving for the HT transformation. So these franchises work very well, and this franchises work very well, and the things gets much improved by using the franchises for improvement of the power supply given to the Jhuggi JJ clusters and unauthorized people and the resettlement areas. So, my dear friend, today what we have discussed? Today we have discussed customer involvement and participation. Non-payment, how to improve non-payment of electricity. Customer satisfaction plays a vital role. We have discussed that point. We have also discussed participation of customer for awareness. Customer feedback, that plays a vital role for improve the whole organizations. And consumer group, and you might have seen that nowadays that school children, they are also coming out for awareness, and you know very well that a particular day, they in a year, they go for massive plantation, and they are also school children can also make awareness program for paying the electricity bill in time, so that the organizations will flourish and everybody should get the electricity, and in that case the franchises scheme plays a very important role. So thank you very much for listening to me. Thank you. If you have any difficulties, you can ask questions to me through my email and all. Thank you very much.